So let's take a look at another awesome engine from BMW, the N55. It was a twin scroll turbocharged engine. It was actually the first straight six engine to use a twin scroll turbocharger. And BMW wanted to continue on the success of their earlier N54 engine and produce a large capacity feel from a turbocharged engine, avoiding the lag, and they've certainly achieved that. You get decent power on the N55 from about 1,250 RPMs all the way up to its red line at 7,000 RPM. Also, throttle response was really good, and part of that was down to the design of the twin scroll turbo, which improved scavenging from the engine, allowing the engine to work much more flexibly. But that also assisted the spool up of the turbo, allowing the turbo speeds to be adjusted much more quickly in line with your throttle response. Please let me know your experiences with the N55 engine. I'd love to hear what mods you've done, what mods you recommend. Maybe there's some things in this video you disagree with. Please let me know. This is how we round out our knowledge, just by comparing notes with other drivers and other vehicle owners, just to give ourselves a good overview of what's out there for the N55 engine. So please let me know what you've done, what you think are good mods, and which mods maybe you've done that you were disappointed with. So the N55 engine really does like high octane fuel, and I've noted that a few owners have converted it to run on E85 and other forms of fuel where they can make much higher power figures just due to the fuel to air ratio being so much higher when you've used these alternative fuels. So the single turbo that was used, it's lighter than the twin turbos that they used to use in the N54. But performance wise, the N54 and the N55 were very similar, producing very similar power outputs. The acceleration times and generally all of the performance stats were very similar between these engines. And the N55 production run was from 2009 to 2015. Power range from 302 horsepower right up to the one that Alpina got their hands on and specially tuned. And they managed to get 425 brake horsepower from the N55 engine. So it's a phenomenally strong engine. So what mods are the ones that give you the good, decent, high power gains? And is it possible to get a decent power bump relatively cheaply on the N55 engine? So they're mods that we're going to be discussing in this video. So when tuning your N55 engine, it's just a good idea to make sure that the base setup is sufficient to handle the power and that you're not losing power just through silly inconsistencies with older parts or older components on your engine. So make sure you're getting a good spark. And most people recommend that you run with slightly cooler spark plugs on any kind of tuned N55 engine. It just gives you a little bit more leeway and resists detonation more easily, and that'll just help you to make your power more easily. So the stock intercooler, it's okay, but there are some upgrades around about 6 to 7.5 inches. So specify an intercooler that is of a correct size for your project. So for larger power, we tend to prefer slightly larger intercoolers. Now, intercoolers themselves won't add power. They resist heat soak for longer periods of time. So heat soak is where the intercooler warms up. So effectively, the job of the intercooler is charging the air as it comes out of the turbo, where it's been compressed and has gained a lot of heat. It goes through the intercooler, which is a radiator that exposes that air charge to fresh, cooler air from outside of the car, and it takes that intake temperature down. And that's what helps you to make more power than you would without one, because cold air carries more oxygen than warmer air would. So straight away, with more oxygen, you're able to burn more fuel and make more power. But as that intercooler warms up, it becomes less and less efficient at doing its job. So you may well start to suffer from heat soak on track days where the power has reached a point and it's starting to tail off a little. So just avoid that from happening by specifying a better quality intercooler on your N55 engine. So turbo upgrades is really where you start making significant power gains on your N55 engine. So a hybrid turbo takes the standard turbo casing and just reworks the internals to give you a faster spooler. So the stock turbo will tend to run out of steam round about 5,500 RPM. A decently set up hybrid turbo can actually lift your power response to another 1,000 RPM or so on top of that and give you a much wider torque band to play with. So where you've got a larger turbo and you're starting to hit power figures of around 400, 500 horsepower, you then need to start thinking about doing those fueling upgrades. You can get fairly cheap charge pipe injection kit that give you more fuel supply, but it's a much easier and cheaper thing to set up. It's a little bit crude, and I know a lot of purists may well be cringing at me even mentioning those. But if you wanted to run one of those other fuel types and you're seeking the higher power figures, but you don't want the complexity of uprating the direct injector, it can be an alternative path that you can take just to help you to satisfy your engine's need for more fuel. Please let me know what experiences you've had with the fuel system on your N55 and whether there's any mods that you particularly recommend with regard to keeping the fueling where it needs to be. So Vargas and Pure Stage make a decent range of turbo upgrade kits that have been specifically designed for the N55 engine, so they take into account its flow characteristic and the typical power output that a driver would want. And although these kits can prove to be quite expensive, they are probably one of the most significant ways to add a lot more power to your N55 engine. So larger turbos giving you about 24 PSI of boost are what you will need if you want to take the power figures to somewhere between 5 and 800 horsepower. So they're pretty serious power figures. There's a lot of other mods that you need to do to support that. Port injection is certainly one of those mods that can help you to achieve those figures, as is switching fuel type. But generally to get those sorts of power figures, you're looking at spending about 8 to 10 grand on your car on upgrades just to make sure that everything stays reliable. So I think for most people watching this video who are just curious about mods, you can't go far wrong with just having a remap and just having a modest change on the turbo. You want to keep as much in the engine as stock as possible, just to avoid the sheer expense of upgrades. And you can get a really nice 100 horsepower bump or so with those relatively simple upgrades and still retain the long-term reliability of your N55 engine that you've come to expect over the years. So one of the easiest power gains you can get on the N55 engine is just to change the mapping inside the computer. And there's a few different approaches to doing this. You can get it flash tuned or remapped, where the car is physically reprogrammed, generally through the onboard diagnostic port, or you can get piggyback devices that take over from the ECU and effectively replace them. And there's a couple of other little modules that allow you access to parameters within the ECU. So there's a big variety of things to choose from out there. You've got the Proceed Rev 3, the COB access ports, the TDI tuning piggyback module, the JB4, which is a very popular device used by a lot of N55 engine owners. So if you've used any of those, please let me know in the comments what your experiences were with those. Frustratingly, in some regions, the flexibility that you can get through a lot of these tuning devices has been somewhat limited due to the fact that you can often get round emissions regulations to bump the power up. And as a result, the manufacturers of those devices facing legal action have had to back off on the parameters that can be changed within the ECU or the extent with which you can tune. But clearly that JB4 unit is the cream of the devices that people use to tune their N55 engine. It's possible with most of these devices to see an easy gain of around 80 horsepower, which for just the software mod is phenomenal. It just shows how over-engineered these engines are and how under-tuned they are from the factory. So induction kits and air intakes allow the car to breathe more easily. And the whole aim of an induction kit or an air intake is to reduce the restriction on the intake. So on a standard engine, you'll find the air intake is adequate. It's not really a restriction. I've seen very few people get a power gain on a stock engine just replacing the induction kit. But when you've started tuning your N55 engine, you may well start to hit a restriction, in which case upgrading the induction kit, the air filter system, can really pay dividends. We've seen around 20% of a power hike on some cases of those tuned projects where the stock factory system had become a big restriction. So you've got products from BMS, K&N, and the VRSF DCIs, but the quality induction kits do cost a fair bit of money. So unless you are hitting a restriction, you're probably best spending that money elsewhere, if I'm completely honest with you. So for the more adventurous tuner on the N55 engine, bear in mind that BMW have done a pretty good job on getting the head designed and flowed, but increasing the flow rate of the head, changing maybe the valve size, getting a 3, 4, 5 angle valve job, will aid the engine's ability to breathe and suck in more fresh air, allowing you to hit those higher power power figures. But in terms of complexity, that is actually a very complex mod. It's certainly not a DIY mod. It's not something you can do at home. I've seen people taking grinding wheels to their engines, and it's quite horrific, really, that people often have this misconception that they can improve a well-designed factory setup with no research and development, and without even putting the head on a flow bench just to ascertain where those points of restriction are and which areas need work. We've got a video on porting and polishing heads. So the twin scroll turbo was fed from banks 1-3 and 4-6, and it was managed by a very capable ECU from Bosch, the MEVD 17.2. So it's nice to see manufacturers pushing these ECUs out into performance engines and really extracting as much power and performance as they can from the engine. So strengthening the internal components on the engine is also a good idea, but only if you want those really high power figures. BMW have done a really good job. You've got a capable engine that is particularly strong. So unless you are pushing those really high power figures for track applications or race applications, it's probably prohibitively expensive to go out and get a redesigned crank and piston. Although changing the pistons will allow you to use a little bit more lift on the valves and maybe even change the camshaft profile. But with the variable valve timing that BMW use and all the intake systems that are set up, it's actually quite hard to get a cam that gives you better characteristic than the standard factory profile. Please let me know in the comments if you've got experience of using camshaft upgrades on your N55 engine, or whether you just feel they're unnecessary, whether you can do a decent job of tuning it without going to the expense of getting a new cam installed. So fueling upgrades are also an essential when you start hitting those higher power figures. We certainly recommend that you exceed the injector's capacity as required by the engine by about 20%. That just gives you a little bit of headroom to play in. So if you want to do a little bit more tuning, or to cope with the way the injectors and the fuel system will degrade over age. So it's not just a question of dumping in more powerful injectors. You need to make an adjustment within the ECU, and you need to make sure that the fuel pump is able to supply enough fuel to those injectors to keep everything running nice and smoothly. You can also get a manifold port injection kit for the N55. So that's commonly used where people start using the alternative fuels, where you need a large amount of fuel to be delivered to the engine, and you don't have the risk of detonation from these higher octane or race spec fuels. So exhaust upgrades are often done on the N55 engine. So again, like the intake on a stock engine, you're not seeing that much of a restriction in the exhaust, certainly not from the cat back. The cat is generally the point of restriction in an exhaust, and getting better designed headers can make a fair difference to the way you get the throttle response, the way the turbo spools up. And there's some really good aftermarket kits around, but bear in mind that in some areas it would be illegal to remove the cat, and in some areas it's illegal to replace the cat with a better flowing sports alternative. But if it's legal to do so in your area, do seek out these better flowing headers and high flow sports catalysts, because they will make a big difference to your tuning project and the flexibility that you get from the engine on your throttle response. So problem areas on the N55 engine, well, thankfully it is relatively reliable because it uses direct injection. There's always the risk of carbon buildup on the valves, and that's something that needs to be addressed as your mileage starts creeping up. And it's fairly easily sorted with a walnut blast. There's a lot of aftermarket treatments that garages can offer, various spray-in solutions that they can apply over a period of time that is extremely effective at removing those carbon deposits that have built up. Don't make the mistake of thinking it's something you can do at home with a can of spray. Those do alleviate some of the carbon buildup, but it's nowhere near as effective as having a professional clean or a professional walnut blast carried out on the head. The PCV, the crankcase valve, is also a bit of a weak spot and problem area, and that can lead to high oil consumption issues. So if you notice that the N55 is drinking a lot of oil, it could well be down to the PCV. So get that addressed and sorted as a priority. Injector problems crop up quite a lot on the N55 engine, and these tend to happen at about 50,000 miles. So it's certainly worth getting those injectors checked for their efficiency. And if the mileage is starting to get up to about 50,000 miles, start thinking about replacing them, but look at the overall fuel system and maybe upgrade it and take that into account with your other tuning mods as well. Around about 650, 700 horsepower, you really should start thinking about toughening up the inside of the engine. Forged rods, forged crank, forged pistons, and other components in the engine that really do take a beating at those higher power figures would certainly make more sense at those sorts of power figures. And also you can alter the compression ratio of the engine, which again gives you as a tuner more flexibility in how the power is delivered and how much power you can extract from the fuel you're using and from the turbo setup that you've specified. So I'm not aware of anyone at the moment who's running 1,000 horsepower on a street legal N55 engine, but if you do know, please let me know. I'd be really interested in the spec they've used to achieve that. But we've certainly seen people approaching the 1,000 brake horsepower figure and creating some really impressive N55 projects. So please let me know what mods you've done on your N55 engine, which mods you feel are the most effective upgrades. I want to do a very detailed video on mods for the N55 engine, and I can't do that without as much feedback as possible from you guys. There's people out there that know the N55 like the back of their hand, and they know the common mistakes people make when they start bolting on parts to the N55. So rather than just talking about the general mods, I would really like to provide that in-depth guide to the N55 engine. It really is a special engine. It's got a big fan base. Please subscribe to the channel, because we've got other stuff coming up on the N55 engine and BMW tuning in general, just to help you to get the best from your car and really maximize your driving enjoyment. So thanks for watching. If you haven't subscribed, please do so. We'd love you to stay tuned, and I'll see you in the next video.